Hello everybody, how are you doing? This is MD Tech here with another video. Today we will be looking at how to upgrade to Windows 10 from Windows 7 or Windows 8.1 for free. Now Windows 10 is still in the technical release phase of development, so it has not been released to the public as a final build yet, which is expected to be released later this year. But if you want to get your hands on the technical preview now, here is how to do it. And also, on a side note, once Windows 10 is released, there will be a point in this video that will be very similar, if not identical, to the process that Windows 7 and Windows 8 upgrade users will be going through. So this review will still be relevant once Windows 10 is released. But as of right now, Microsoft has not finalized the release of Windows 10. Which is designed for developers and hobbyists. It should not be used on productive machines that are required for personal use or business, as there could be crashes that could damage or even delete some files. So make sure you back up all of your important documents before upgrading to Windows 10. Doesn't matter if it's a technical release or the final build, I would always suggest backing up files, especially when you do an operating system upgrade. Going on our internet browser here. Now in the URL address bar, type in insider.windows.com. Now we need to sign into our Windows Live account. So I'm just going to sign into mine right here. Now it is important to note that you need a Microsoft account in order to access and download the Microsoft preview. As of now, the system requirements in order to run the Windows technical preview is a 1 GHz processor or faster, and at least 1 GB of RAM. 2 GB would be recommended at a minimum, and you have to have at least 16 GB of free hard disk space available. And you also have to have a Microsoft account and internet access in order to get the technical release preview from Microsoft's website. Okay, so if you have not already made an Insider account, it might ask you to go for a couple additional steps, but eventually you will get to this page saying, "Welcome back, Insider." So now we have access to downloading the technical release build. And what you want to do is you want to click, go down towards the bottom of the page. Under Windows 10 Technical Preview, click Get Started for the PC. And now you got to scroll down here. Click on Get the Preview. Now start upgrade now. Now depending on the browser you're using, this might look a little bit different, but since we're using Internet Explorer, we're gonna go right down here and click the Run button. Now what this will do is it'll initiate a download. What is important about this download is that it will communicate to Windows Update to download the Windows 10 technical preview, and it is through Windows Update that we will be upgrading to Windows 10. So now we will click on yes. Now once this is done downloading, it'll ask us to restart the computer. Now this is the first upgrade version of Windows that does not require an installer to be mounted to a CD or USB or another type of media. It is a more automatic process that is completed through Windows Update. Obviously, they are trying to attract more users to Windows 10, and not only is Windows 10 going to be a free update for the first year for Windows 7 and Windows 8 users, but it will also be a lot easier for less experienced users to just automatically be updated to Windows 10 if they're already receiving Windows updates automatically. So like I said, the computer is going to restart here, and once the computer is rebooted, I will be back. Hello everybody, Windows has restarted. Now from this point on in the review, the installation process of upgrading to Windows 10 should be nearly identical to that of the technical preview that we are updating to today. We see that it's about 2.2 gigabytes, so it's a very, very, very large update. It'd be very hard to mistake this with any other Patch Tuesday update you might get from Microsoft. When the final version is released, Microsoft will more than likely just get rid of the technical preview part of this title. Now depending on the size of the hard drive and the speed of your computer, it will vary on how long this update will take. we can see that it's already moving. Right now we're already about 6%. So I will come back once the update has finished downloading, and I will be right back. Hello everybody, I'm back. Now we have a Windows 10 technical preview setup pop up here. It says thank you for signing up for the Windows 10 technical preview. Let's get started. Now, I would suggest that anybody installing this reads the release software licensing terms or end user license agreement, but I would just click accept here. And right now it's checking our PC to make sure that we meet the system requirements for an upgrade to Windows 10. Okay, so now we see that the update was successfully installed. Now it is suggesting that we save our work. They're going to keep our files, apps, and programs. They'll be ready for us to use after our update. And it appears you could schedule the update, but we're going to start the upgrade right now. Okay, so it is restarting our computer, and it will launch the Windows 10 installer once we begin booting back up. So as the computer is restarting, we see that Microsoft is currently updating our operating system, and right now they call it a configuring update for Windows 10 technical preview. This will be different come the final release of Windows 10. Hello everybody, the computer is starting back up into the setup files for Windows 10. We can see that our Windows 7 administrator username is right here, so that has remained intact. I will click on next to continue the installation. Basically, we're going to use express settings here. We're going to keep everything default. Now, if this was my own personal computer, I would actually go through some of the settings to make sure that everything was just how I like it. I know there are some things about privacy that can be customized in the settings about, like, do not track on websites and cookies and all that other kind of stuff, geographic location tracking. So definitely I would recommend going through the customized settings if this was your own personal computer. Now we're just going to fast forward for this section. I'll just keep it up on the screen. I don't know how long it is going to take. See that right now we are installing some drivers for my microphone and appears to be speakers on this virtual machine. And we see that our computer shortcut that was on the desktop for Windows 7 has been changed to the Windows 10 icon. Just ignore that one pop-up there. We can also notice that our desktop background has not changed after upgrading. And there we go, guys. That's pretty much how you upgrade from Windows 7 to Windows 10. I would imagine the process would be a little bit quicker once the final version is released and the servers are running at a much greater demand. And pretty much everything updating through Windows Update is going to remain the same, or it should remain the same through the next year, as all Windows 7 and Windows 8.1 users will get free upgrades to Windows 10 as of now for 1 year following the official release of Windows 10, which has not occurred yet. So I hope you guys liked the video, and I will talk to you later. Bye.